गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ द लेसन कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन। बिफोर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑफ ब्रेन, वी हैव टू स्टडी द सेल्स ऑफ नर्व्स, ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड विच इज कॉल्ड न्यूरॉन। ऑल द न्यूरल कंट्रोल्स आर रिलेटेड टू न्यूरॉन। ऑल द नर्व्स, आइदर दे आर क्रेनियल नर्व्स और दे आर स्पाइनल नर्व्स और ब्रेन और स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, ऑल आर मेड अप ऑफ द सेल्स विच आर कॉल्ड न्यूरॉन। हियर इज द फिगर ऑफ अ मल्टीपोलर न्यूरॉन। न्यूरॉन इज ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स, यूनिपोलर, बाइपोलर एंड मल्टीपोलर। यूनिपोलर न्यूरॉन इज दैट टाइप ऑफ न्यूरॉन विच हैज ओनली अ सेल बॉडी कॉल्ड साइटोन एंड अ सिंगल लॉन्ग प्रोसेस अराइज फ्रॉम साइटोन विच इज कॉल्ड एक्सॉन। इफ देयर इज अ साइटोन एंड वन process axon, then it is called a unipolar neuron. In bipolar neuron, two processes arise from cyton. One process, a small process, is called dendron, and one long process opposite to dendron is called axon, at right at 180 degree to each other, opposite to each other. If the neuron has two processes, then it is called a bipolar neuron. Here is the figure of a multipolar neuron. Multipolar neuron is that type of neuron in which there is a cell body cyton, in which a long process arises, which is called axon, and numerous small processes arise from cyton, which are called dendron. We study a multipolar neuron and the function of neuron, how it functions. See the figure of a multipolar neuron. Here is the cell body which is called cyton. In cyton is just like a cell. There are numerous large small processes arise from cyton which are called dendron, and one long process arises from cyton which is called axon. And all dendrons divided into a number of fine branches. These branches are called dendrites. That means a small processes arise from cyton are called dendron, and the branching of dendron are called dendrites. Now one long process is called axon. Axon is divided into two terminal branches, and each terminal branches divides into a number of fine branches which ends at knob like structure which are called synaptic knobs. Now in cell body cyton, the protoplasm present in cyton are called neuroplasm, and in neuroplasm there are several granules which are present in cyton. These are called Nissl's granules. Nissl's granules are actually ribosomes, and there are several fibrils in the cyton. These fibrils are called neurofibrils. Neurofibrils and Nissl's granules are the characteristics of neuron. They are not present in all other cells. And remaining all the cell organelles.
Once again, I am going to repeat the structure of a multipolar neuron. A multipolar neuron has a cell body, cyton. A long process arises from cyton which is called axon, and several small processes arise from cyton. These are called dendrons, and the branching of dendrons are called dendrites. Axon is also divided into two terminal branches, and these terminal branches again divides into fine branches, and these fine branches has a nerve like structure which are called synaptic nerve. Now in cell body or cyton, the cytoplasm of cell body or cyton is called neuroplasm. It contains nucleus, all the cell organelles present in general cell. Besides the all cell organelle, some nacelles, granules and neurofibrils are also present in cyton of cell body, which is not present in general cells. That means besides all other cell organelles, nacelles, granules and neurofibrils are two special organelles present in only cyton of neuron. Now axon is also called nerve fiber. Nerve fiber is covered by two layered covering. Inner layer is made up of fatty material which is called myelin sheath, and outer layer is made up of cells which are called neurilemma or swarm cells. At some places both myelin sheath and swarm cells absent. These places are called node of Ranvier. In some axon both the myelin sheath and neurilemma or swarm cells absent, and the nerve fiber which do not have both the covering are called non-medullated nerve fiber, and the nerve fiber which has both the covering are called medullated nerve fiber. On the basis of covering present on axon, nerve fiber is of two types: non-medullated nerve fiber and medullated nerve fiber. Non-medullated nerve fiber do not have any covering, but medullated nerve fiber have both the covering. Now we are going to discuss the working of a multipolar neuron, how it works. The nerve impulses are received in the form of stimulus by our sense organ. We have five sense organ: eye, ear, nose, tongue and skin. These are also called receptor organs. The receptor organ receive stimuli from the environment, and this stimuli is changed into electrical impulses by the dendrites of neuron, and these electrical impulses now passes from dendrites to dendron, from dendron to cyton, and from cyton to axon, and axon transmit the nerve impulses into their fine branches, and from the fine branches of axon it goes to the synaptic nerve. In synaptic nerve the electrical impulses again change into chemicals. Now these chemicals diffuses to the dendrites of other neuron. Other neuron receive chemical, and these chemicals again change into electrical impulses, and electrical impulses transmitted in the same way from dendrites to dendron, from dendron to cyton, from cyton to axon, from axon to its terminal branches, and terminal branches to fine branches, and then synaptic nerve. That means at synaptic nerve the transmission of impulse occurs in the form of chemicals, and the nerve impulses transmitted in the form of electrical impulses. Now if the neurons are terminal neuron, then the synaptic nerve ends into muscles, and muscles receive the order of brain in a spinal cord and function accordingly. And if the neuron is intermediate neuron, then the synaptic nerve of one neuron is attached to the dendrites of other neuron, and nerve impulses are transmitted from one neuron to other neuron. that means in whole brain or a spinal cord or nerves arising from brain and a spinal cord, that is cranial nerves and spinal nerves, all are made up of neurons. So before we study the structure and function of brain, we have to study the working of a multipolar neuron. So today I am discussing the structure and function of a multipolar neuron. What are the organs, parts of multipolar neuron, and how it functions? In next class, we study the structure and function of human brain.